Maybe we can still heal you.
Why? So you can just lock me up? Nah. Just bury me in the ocean with my ancestors that jumped from the ships. Because they knew death was better than bondage.
In our Marvel news, this is going to make Larry happy because for whatever the reason, Larry does not want Killmonger to die.
He's not dead. Killmonger is the hero of Wakanda and of the world.
Here we go. And there has been a prevailing rumor, I don't know if it's fan-made or true, that Killmonger, if you guys remember when he died, he said, bury me in the oceans where my ancestors are, who jumped from the ships because they knew death was better than bondage. So the prevailing fan theory is maybe Killmonger did get to the bottom of the ocean and somewhere in Atlantis, and during the snap, he somehow or another got resurrected. He goes and talks to Namor about his hatred for Wakanda, and now him and Namor team up to come back, to destroy, to lay waste, to incinerate, to inspire fear, hatred, and debauchation on Wakanda. Larry, I know you love to see that, wouldn't you?
Oh yeah, I would love to see that. I would love to see them come in together and for Killmonger to take his rightful place on the throne of Wakanda. That would be absolutely incredible.
Do you think Namor going to let his ass sit on the throne of Wakanda after he brings him back?
He might.
No.
He might, you know, because a lot of those ocean folks are pretty much like, look, we're only up here because you fools won't leave us alone. I'm going to put our dude here. He's going to be like, we're not touching them ever. And then they can go back to the ocean and live their lives, you know?
Well, if that's really and truly the case, they're being no more better isolationists than what Wakanda was doing.
Well, Wakanda was doing their thing as far as isolation, boy. Yeah. They're like the self-distancing champions.
Exactly. T-Streams, would you like to see Killmonger come back as kind of the middle ground villain to the main villain of Namor in Black Panther 2?
If they did, man, I would really be interested in seeing how they pull it off. You know, I don't know if falling down to the middle of the ocean and the ocean ghost resurrecting you is satisfying for me, but.
Hey, how did we get Captain America? They plucked him out of the ocean, the bottom of the ocean frozen. And that's how we got Captain America.
Yeah. And so I'm interested to see how that would fall through. It could possibly work out, but if they bring him back, they got to make sure that is done right. It can't be anything just too cheesy, man.
Yeah. I have complete faith in Ryan Coogler. I would normally say I have faith in Kevin Feige, but let me use that as the way to transition into my next story about Marvel. So I think Larry has been clamoring for it. My homeboy James Booker, shout out to him, has been clamoring for it. Everybody has pretty much liked the Deadpool movies. Now they're rated R.
Deadpool is probably one of my favorite joints in Marvel. It might be my favorite.
Now they're rated R, and you know Marvel now has the rights to Deadpool. And Kevin Feige has been hell-bent that he is not doing any R-rated movies. And so someone very, very close to the first two movies had this to say in regards to Kevin Feige and what Marvel plans to do with Deadpool and the Uncanny. Here we go.
No Deadpool or X-Force in production. Rob Liefeld blames Kevin Feige. What he actually had to say was very different. This is a quote, and again, coming from the Inverse podcast, which he went on live and re-reported by comicbook.com. This is what he had to say about Deadpool and the upcoming Marvel Studios involvement with the project. We got two brilliant movies, and we live in a culture that always looks forward because they're ever selling us next, next, next. It's the fever. For me, as the fever calms down, people just need to calm down and realize Deadpool 1 and 2 were released within 2 years of each other, 2016 and 2018, and I'm not really crazy about what Marvel's plan is right now. He goes on to say, it's the first time I go, hey Kevin, do you even have a plan? Your plan was Eternals and Shang-Chi? That was your plan? And Black Widow? So they close the door, Chris Evans says goodbye, Robert Downey Jr. says goodbye, Black Widow falls off a cliff and says goodbye. They almost lose Tom Holland to Sony, but you're a genius, Marvel. You're a genius.
Damn. No. Boy,
that dude man feels all kinds of ways.
That man sound like he want him some Deadpool. Now, it is true. They have not made any determination on Deadpool whether they're going to drop it or make it. T-Streams, how do you feel about Deadpool, and what do you think Marvel's intentions are going to be with a rated R movie? And you know your executive is not a fan of rated R.
Man, you need something for the big guys, for the adults.
Right.
Keep it. You know, it's nothing, you know, in both of those movies are tremendously entertaining. You know, I watched both of them. I like them. And I think that it has a potential future. Go ahead and do it. You know, there's a small thin line anyway between PG-13 and rated R. A little bit extra blood and a few extra more curse words. So, you know.
Right?
You know, it really don't even make a difference. So, and then too, you know, when you think of it, hell, all the movies should be rated R. You should be able to see some blood if they doing all that fighting and stuff like that. But I think it's more concerned, they're more concerned about their image with the kids and all this other kind of stuff. But keep something for the adults. You know, it's brandable. It already has a fan base for it. It's good.
Larry, I know this is your puppy, man. Vent about Deadpool 3.
I mean, I get why they wouldn't want to make it rated R, especially since it's going to be a Disney property. They want to make sure that it is as broadly available to the Disney audience as possible. Mm-hmm. And if it's a PG-13 movie, it's easy to slap it up there on the Disney Plus thing and say, hey, everybody can watch it. They don't have to do anything special to sort of separate it out from the other other movies. But if they're not going to make it rated R, I think they should maybe have, what's his name, directed? The dude, what's his name? James Gunn? Mm-hmm. The dude that did Guardians?
Yeah.
Because he did a good job with making Guardians funny and a little bit risque in such a way that adults really enjoyed it, but it was still funny and kid-like, kid-friendly to a certain extent. So I'm not sure if you can do that with Deadpool entirely, because I feel like Deadpool is,
he's rated R. I mean,
even in the comics, he was, I mean, all the Marvel comics, really, when you read the comic books, none of them should be rated anything less than R if you read the comic books, but Deadpool in particular. So, I would like to see it keep its rated R. You know, it's R rating, and let us just enjoy it for what it is. Not everything has to be for the kids, you know, so. Well, it's what it is.
The thing is, are we going to get the movie? When are we going to get the movie? We're just in a stalemate right now. So
yeah, they're probably not in no big rush to do it. But here's the thing: Disney knew that before they even purchased Marvel. So you know they was already aware that, you know, this is what comes with the territory. You can't purchase something and then try to bend it and make everything Mickey Mouse-ish. It's just not going to work that way. And if they, you know, if they try to continue that model, you know, it's going to hurt the brand. At least the Marvel brand, it'll hurt it.
You know? I don't know, man. I don't know. You're talking about one movie out of a series of movies that have been good, and none of them have really been rated R.
Yeah.
Well, I'll say this: when it comes to Deadpool, part of their thing that they've done with him is they've had a lot of fun poking fun at the characters, the actors, the, you know, Marvel itself. They've had fun poking confronted all of that inside of the movie, sort of breaking character a little bit. Like, I think of the scene where he went to where he went up there and he signed that mutant kid's cereal box, and he signed it Ryan Reynolds.
Right.
And, you know, they do little stuff like that all the time. So they could make it funny where they poke fun at Disney and say, "What do you mean I can't cuss? That's some bull." And every time he tries to cuss, like a bleep comes off out of his mouth, like a visual bleep comes out of his mouth, you know, or something silly, some way that expresses how often he cusses and how much they're bleeping him out or censoring him. I think they could do it and make it funny. So
I would like to see him team up with Howard the Duck.
Haven't brought Howard back in yet, except for that little short bit.
Yeah, I want to see him team up with Howard the Duck, my favorite little hero duck. So
yeah,
let's get that popping, and
let's get that going.
We got one more Marvel story, and this one involves a movie that is 2 years and a half old, The New Mutants. Fellas, we have a theatrical release date. This movie is set to drop in theaters. I don't know what the conditions of the theaters is going to be. I don't know what is going to be happening around this time. But this movie is set to drop August the 28th of this year. I think it's going to die a fiery death. And it could be a situation where they're going to try to drop it in the movie for 2 weeks, depending upon what's going on with the Rona during that era. But it's set to go in August. T-Streams, what do you think is going to happen when it's time for this movie to come out? August is very close.
August is very close. I think that they really, you know, right now they didn't really have no choice. But, hey, drop it, push it, let it do what it do. You know, they've already been sitting on it for 2 years. Ain't no need to sit on it longer. Just, you know, put it out. Let people get their appetite wet with getting back comfortable with going to the movie theater. After a couple weeks, slide it on Disney Plus or wherever you're going to put it, call it a wrap, and look forward to future projects. But you got to get something out there. Now, by it being that close to the curb of this pandemic stuff, you know, it may not be very many people in there, so it may not do very well as it would have, you know, as it would have had this situation not been going on. But, you know, that's just something that you're going to have to see. I mean, well, damn, how long do you really want to keep tabling this project? Push it out there, you know?
Does Disney have this one, or is this a Sony one?
No, it's Disney.
It's Disney?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I'm thinking, like, this is what I would do if I was Disney. I would release this in July, and I would say, you know, I would say it's gonna be a rental. It's not gonna be just included with the Disney Plus thing. It's gonna be a rental. But what I would do is I would say you pay the $19.99 to rent it, and you get 2 months of free Disney Plus. Mm-hmm. So you figure Disney Plus right now is what, $7.99 a month or $6.99 a month?
No.
So, something, you know, dirty. You figure that's what, seven, so 2 months is about $14. So you're really only paying, you know, you're really only paying a couple of bucks for the actual rental, and then you get to watch Disney Plus for 2 months. So, And you get to boost your subscription, and most likely once people get into Disney Plus, they'll just keep it. Oftentimes people get these subscriptions and they forget they even have them. So they just keep them. Yeah. So,
well, Larry,
that's what I would do. Well, I mean, because what's the point of putting it in a theater that only is going to have, at minimum, I mean, they're only going to allow them to have like a third of the people, if even that. Right. And then a lot of people still aren't going to want to show up. It's just...
To me, I really think that they're just going to put it in theater for a month and then try to resell it on Disney Plus and then try to drop DVDs of it. That's what I think.
I wouldn't even go a month. That's just us. You know what happens, though? You have a month, and the movie better be straight fire. Because you put it out in the theaters and people are like, "Oh, we've been waiting for this for 2 years and it's garbage." And then you try and release it on VOD and people are like, "I'm not paying for that."
Man.
You know?
Larry, I don't know how much more fire you're going to get for something that was really made 3 years ago.
And that's what I'm saying. They should just go ahead and put it out on Disney Plus.
I agree.
Are you buying DVDs?
Hey, huh? People buy DVDs.
Are people still buying DVDs?
People still buying Blu-ray.
People do.
Yeah.
But I mean, some of these things, like if you plan on having, you know, Disney Plus as a subscription, why should you go out and buy all the Marvel series movies on DVD when you can just be like, oh, I want to watch The Avengers. Blink, it's on. Oh, I want to watch Black Panther. Blink, it's on. I want to watch Civil War. Blink. Instead of having to go grab your DVD, put it in your Xbox or put it in your Sony player, whatever you have, and then go watch it. I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. I mean, I think it's great for people who don't have subscription services and don't want them. But other than that, I don't even really see the need for them anymore.
Yeah. Well, that's going to table our Marvel conversations